Allahu, Allahu, Allah, Allah.
Par excellence presents Jewels from the Holy Quran, a series of lectures by Mufti Ismail ibn Musa Menk.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, in the name of Allah, most gracious, most merciful. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, creator of entire creation. Wa usalli wa usallim ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Complete blessings and salutations be upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and all his companions. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us knowledge that is beneficial and to benefit us from the knowledge that He has granted us. Also, we seek the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from eyes that will not cry for His sake, from a stomach and a belly that will not be filled, and from a heart that will not tremble in fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We also seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's protection from knowledge that we make no use of. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. Honored ulama, beloved brothers and sisters, and dearest listeners, we commenced with the second part of Surah Yasin in tonight's recitation, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about a certain man in Surah Yasin. That man was not a prophet, but he was the one who went to his people and he communicated with his people. He told his people, why don't you follow the messengers? Why don't you follow the messengers who are asking you nothing material? They don't want wealth from you. They want nothing from you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of how they did not listen to him, and how they accused him of being mad and so on. And thereafter Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that we told him after his death to enter Jannah. And he said, Ya layta qawmi ya'lamuna bima ghafara li rabbi wa ja'alani minal mukramin. How I wish my people would have known how Allah has treated me post-death. The fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven me and He has made me from amongst the honored ones. Who are the honored ones? Those who earn Jannah after their death. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant that to us as well. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of that man.
وَجَاءَ مِنْ أَقْصَى الْمَدِينَةِ رَجُلٌ يَسْعَى قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اتَّبِعُوا الْمُرْسَلِينَ اتَّبِعُوا مَنْ لَا يَسْأَلُكُمْ أَجْرًا وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ
A man came running from the inner part of the city, telling his people, follow the messengers, follow those who are commanding that which is good and prohibiting that which is evil. Follow those who do not want any material wealth in return for what they are telling you. They have come with a message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear listeners, we should remember one thing. These ears of ours were created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَا أَصَابَكَ لَمْ يَكُلْ لِيُخْطِئَكَ وَمَا أَخْطَأَكَ لَمْ يَكُلْ لِيُصِيبَكَ That which got to you was never ever meant to miss you, even by a fraction. And that which missed you, even by a fraction, was never ever meant to get to you. Now, the meaning of that is very vast. We can take it to the bullets that miss us, they were never meant to get us. And we can take it to any sustenance that gets to us, it was never meant to miss us. And something that missed us was not meant to get to us. The same applies to the words that our ears listen to. Sometimes we listen to a CD, sometimes we listen to the radio, sometimes we read a book, sometimes we listen to a cassette, sometimes we go and sit in a lecture of someone. The words that come to my ears and yours, they were selected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to come to my ears. If they are good, Allah is going to ask us, I sent a message to your ears designed for you. How did you react? Did you take heed or not? And if those words are bad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask us and He'll tell us, bad words came to your ears. Did you block your ears in any way? Or did you do something about stopping yourself from listening to that bad? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our ears from those ears that listen to good. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives good news towards the last verses that we read tonight. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, give good news to my worshippers, whom when they listen to something, they follow the best of it.
فَبَشِّرْ عِبَادِ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَهُ أُولَئِكَ الَّذِينَ هَدَاهُمُ اللَّهُ وَأُولَئِكَ هُمْ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ.
Give glad tidings to my worshippers who listen to the speeches and to the lectures and who listen to whatever comes to their ears, but only follow the best of it and they stay away from the bad. When someone talks to us, sometimes part of the speech is unacceptable and part of it is acceptable. The good news is for those who can distinguish between the two types of news and who only accept that which is good. Allah says those are the ones who are intelligent, full of intellect. And those are the ones whom Allah has rightly guided. May Allah guide us all. In Surah Yasin, moments after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks of Qiyamah. And He speaks of how the world will come to an end. And He says,
وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ فَإِذَا هُمْ مِنَ الْأَجْدَاثِ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَنْسِلُونَ قَالُوا يَا وَيْلَنَا مَنْ بَعَثَنَا مِنْ مَرْقَدِنَا.
When the trumpet shall be blown, you will find everyone being resurrected from their resting places, from their graves, and they will utter the words, who has brought us up from our resting places? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's response,
هَذَا مَا وَعَدَ الرَّحْمَنُ وَصَدَقَ الْمُرْسَلُونَ.
This is what the Most Merciful has promised you. And definitely all the messengers were speaking the truth when they were reminding you of Qiyamah. May Allah make us prepare for the day we die, inshallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about how people will be caught when the trumpet is blown. And I've explained there are two Qiyamah. One is that small Qiyamah when I die and you die. And one is the major Qiyamah when the trumpet is blown and creation comes to an end. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
مَا يَنظُرُونَ إِلَّا صَيْحَةً وَاحِدَةً تَأْخُذُهُمْ وَهُمْ يَخِصِّمُونَ.
Are they waiting for a sudden sound, a huge tremor that will overtake them whilst they are debating and arguing with one another? Is that what they are waiting for in order to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? May Allah make us strong. We should not be waiting for various items and signs and the punishment to come before we turn. We are fortunate. We will turn inshallah here and now today for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before it is too late. May Allah soften our hearts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the hearts. Towards the end of the verses we read tonight, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
أَفَمَنْ شَرَحَ اللَّهُ صَدْرَهُ لِلْإِسْلَامِ فَهُوَ عَلَى نُورٍ مِّنْ رَبِّهِ.
Do you see the one whom Allah has opened his chest and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has cleansed his heart and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has cleared him so that he sees with the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he can see this Islam. He can see this submission. He can follow the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says,
فَوَيْلٌ لِلْقَاسِيَةِ قُلُوبُهُمْ مِنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ.
Destruction be upon those whose hearts are hardened and they don't remember Allah. Destruction be upon those whose hearts are hardened. What is the meaning of a heart hard? Meaning a hard heart. What is the meaning of a hard heart? The hard heart is that heart which no matter how many reminders come to it, it does not even tremble in the fear of Allah. It does not remember Allah. It does not take heed. A heart that sees the signs of Allah, it sees the punishment of Allah, it sees so much, and still it remains so solid, and it just feels, you know what, I'm healthy, death can't come to me. Let me carry on enjoying my life. That is a hard heart. May Allah protect us from that heart. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, regarding the Quran,
اللَّهُ نَزَّلَ أَحْسَنَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابًا مُتَشَابِهًا مَثَانِي.
Allah has revealed the most beautiful of speech, the most beautiful of words. That book which is similar. Don't we see every night the verses are quite similar. They remind us of the similar things. Do right and abstain from bad. They remind us of Qiyamah, they remind us of the punishment, and they remind us of how to be good and obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and good to fellow human beings and other creatures and how to abstain from bad. The verses are all quite similar. And they have the stories of the past and they have rules and regulations governing how we shall deal with one another. Allah says, we have revealed the best of books which has similar verses and which is repeated often. We find verses of the Quran are repeated often. Surah Al-Fatiha is repeated. That is why one of the names of Surah Al-Fatiha, As-Sab'ul Mathani, the seven verses that are often repeated. That is one of the names of Surah Al-Fatiha. So Allah says, we have revealed such a beautiful book. In it, there are similar verses and they are repeated so many times.
تَقْشَعِرُّ مِنْهُ جُلُودُ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ ثُمَّ تَلِينُ جُلُودُهُمْ وَقُلُوبُهُمْ إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ.
The true believers, their skin crumbles up and shrivels up and their hairs stand when they hear the verses of Allah being recited to them. And immediately after that, their hearts soften up and incline towards the obedience of Allah. So if you want to see and gauge yourself, how close am I to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When verses of the Quran are recited, warning me and you, reminding me and you, if we tremble in fear and immediately our hearts soften up and incline towards worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is a sign of iman. That is a sign that inshallah there is still a flicker of hope and there is still a candle in there which has the flame of iman on it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really rekindle that flame of iman in our hearts in this month of Ramadan. So Allah beautifully describes it and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that those are the ones whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guided. And those are the ones who are intelligent. Once again, Allah uses the same word, intelligent. Because a person who has a brain will realize that he is coming to an end. He is growing old. And very soon he is going to come to an end. And he needs to prepare or she needs to prepare for the day they meet with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah grant us all the ability to prepare for that day. May He take us away with shahada on our tongues and may He grant us Jannah without even reckoning. Because He is able and capable of doing that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks of that towards the end. But in Surah Yasin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about how on the day of Qiyamah, the criminals, they will say, who brought us up from this place that we were sleeping? And they will be told that this is the promise of Allah and the messengers have spoken the truth. And Allah will say, today you can bear witness against yourselves. And if you don't want, Allah says, listen to the verse.
الْيَوْمَ نَخْتِمُ عَلَىٰ أَفْوَاهِهِمْ.
On this day we shall seal their mouths. We will close their mouths. If they don't want to talk, we will ask them to plead. If they don't want to plead this way or that way, we will then seal their mouths. We don't need the mouths to speak.
وَتُكَلِّمُنَا أَيْدِيهِمْ وَتَشْهَدُ أَرْجُلُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ.
Their hands will speak out to us. If you take a moment to look at your fingers and you imagine these fingers developing tongues of their own and bearing witness, Ya Allah, I did not want to touch X, Y, and Z, but this person forced me and I am bearing witness against him. Imagine our own hands. May Allah make us use our hands only in the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The legs will say, Ya Allah, I did not want to walk to the discos and the casinos and the nightclubs and so on, but this person forced me and I'm bearing witness against this person. Didn't we utter last night that even the hair shall speak? That Ya Allah, I wanted to be covered in the case of the females, but this female did not cover me. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. So these faculties of ours might just become our enemies. Now one might ask, so what if I've already done bad? Is there any hope for me? The answer is yes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, don't lose hope in my mercy. Do you know when you seek forgiveness, the hands forget what you did. The feet forget what you did. The bricks that bore witness or that bear witness regarding what we have done, if we have committed a sin, the bricks, instead of bearing witness against us, they will be made to forget what happened. And even the angels who record whatever is recorded, they will also be made to forget. Allahu Akbar. That is what Tawbah does. That is what repentance does. So it is not too late. All of us, because of our human nature, we err, we make mistakes, we sin sometimes. Remember, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before it is too late. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take us to Jannah. And in Surah Yasin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also speaks about the people of Jannah and how they will be so happy and how their gifts shall be given to them. That description is in Surah Yasin. One verse that I'd like to explain of scientific importance. In Surah Yasin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks of some of his signs. And one of the signs he says,
وَآيَةٌ لَهُمُ اللَّيْلُ نَسْلَخُ مِنْهُمْ النَّهَارَ فَإِذَا هُمْ مُظْلِمُونَ.
One of the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the night. We peel off the daylight, so suddenly they are in complete darkness. The term peeling is used. This means that the daylight is a thin layer around the globe, around the earth. That is daylight. Do you know that the scientists have discovered, and it's not very difficult to understand, that when the sun shines on the earth, there is a glow. When I look at the sun from the earth, I cannot look at it directly, unless it's about to set. I cannot look at it directly, otherwise it will mess my eyes. I will destroy the vision that Allah has given me in my eyes. I can't look at it. And the sun appears very differently. But if I were to cross a certain threshold, go into space, I will be able to look at the sun. And the moon is lit by the same sun that lights the earth. But daylight is only a gift given to those on earth. It is one layer of a few kilometers around the earth solely. When you go onto the moon, and people have been onto the moon, I hope they haven't hoaxed us. People have been onto the moon, and they will tell you that the light there is a different light. It is more like a white fluorescent lamp. It is not the yellow burning light that we find here on earth. It is a white light, and it is a cool light. It is not the hot light that we have here. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. Allah has given us that information in this surah to say that daylight, and the daylight that we actually see, the reflection of the sun's rays off what is known in the Arabic language as haba'a. Sometimes early morning we open the window and we see little particles and the sun's rays are coming through the window. Those little particles are what cause the daylight. Allahu Akbar. This is spoken about in the Quran, and the scientists have actually discovered it and they make mention of it. Something very interesting. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to understand how gifted we are to have been given this Quran, and to be from amongst those who are followers of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks at the end of Surah Yasin about how the question arose. Those people who disbelieve, they ask the question, who is going to give life to us after we have become decomposed in the soil? مَن يُحْيِي الْعِظَامَ وَهِيَ رَمِيمٌ. Who is going to give life to these bones after they are decomposed in the soil? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds and says,
قُلْ يُحْيِيهَا الَّذِي أَنْشَأَهَا أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ.
The one who gave it life in the first place when it was nothing, he is the one who will bring it back to life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about how he is going to give it back, meaning how he's going to bring it back to life. He says in the Quran, in another place, he says that it is easier for us to bring back to life that which is decomposed than to give life to that which is non-existent. Do we see the difference? If Allah can give life to something without it being there at all, surely it's easier to give life to something that's there but now decomposed. Like a person has Lego. The Lego is decomposed. It's easier for them to sit and to make the thing than to sit and say, be. We can say be a billion times. It's not going to come because we are not Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
إِنَّمَا أَمْرُهُ إِذَا أَرَادَ شَيْئًا أَن يَقُولَ لَهُ كُن.
When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants anything, he just has to say kun, which means be, and it is.
فَيَكُونَ,
and it is. Allahu Akbar. So Allah says, كُنْ أَمْرُهُ بَيْنَ الْكَافِ وَالنُّونَ. His command is between a kaf and a noon. Between those two letters, that's the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He creates things from nothing. And this is why when people say, you know what, that man created this and this man created that, the true word is invented. Because a person can dig the mountains and take what Allah has placed in there and convert it from one form to another, and thereafter get steel, and from the steel they can then convert it to a motor vehicle and so on. They can't say we created the motor vehicle. Tell them, all of you get together and say B. Let's see if that car is there. Wallahi, we will have to send them to the mad hospital if they think they can do that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. So it is only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who creates in that way. In the next surah, Surah As-Saffat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the shayateen. And Allah speaks about the stars in some of the opening verses. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
إِنَّا زَيَّنَّا السَّمَاءَ الدُّنْيَا بِزِينَةٍ الْكَوَاكِبِ وَحِفْظًا مِّن كُلِّ شَيْطَانٍ مَارِدٍ.
Allah says, we have beautified the sky above the dunya with the beauty of the stars. So these stars are there to beautify the skies. That's the first reason. The second reason, to protect the heavens from those shayateen who want to try and get there without permission. So any shaitan who tries to cross beyond a certain point is pelted with the same stars. So when we see a star falling, we are taught to say, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-ali al-azim. There is no power, no might besides that of Allah, all high, almighty, all great. That is the power of Allah. He uses the star to pelt the shayateen. So that is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in another place in the Quran,
وَعَلَامَاتٍ وَبِالنَّجْمِ هُمْ يَهْتَدُونَ.
The fact that these stars are there to guide people when they are walking by night. When they are traveling by night, you see the north star and you know that now you are heading north. You see the other star and you know that now we are heading in this direction and this is where it is. People in the villages, they still use the stars. With us, mashallah, we have satellite navigation and we have various other gadgets and various instruments and roads and road signs. So we are very lazy. We don't even know what the stars are all about. We hardly look at it. Yet Allah says, just to watch the stars is an act of worship. Do we know that? Just to look at the stars, because it is a sign of the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, automatically it is an act of worship. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us strong. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks of that. We should also remember that fortune telling is haram. To go to fortune tellers is also haram. One hadith takes it as far as kufr.
مَنْ أَتَى عَرَّافًا أَوْ كَاهِنًا فَصَدَّقَهُ بِمَا أَخْبَرْ فَقَدْ كَفَرَ بِمَا أُنزِلَ عَلَى مُحَمَّدٍ.
Whosoever goes to a fortune teller and believes the fortune teller, they have disbelieved in what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has come with. Clear cut hadith. So we must ask Allah's protection. Nobody can tell us our fortune. We must remember that. And those who use the stars and they say, no, the Quran says the stars will guide us, that is not the guidance that was being spoken about, not the astrology. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is speaking of the guidance when it comes to the roads by night. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks in Surah As-Saffat about His worshippers whom He has chosen. And He repeats the term. After punishing the people, Allah says,
إِلَّا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ الْمُخْلَصِينَ.
We saved and protected a certain class of people. Who were those? They were those worshippers of mine who were chosen and selected. The word مُخْلَص means those who are chosen. And the word مُخْلِص means those who are sincere. So the difference between the two is a fatha and a kasra. And the difference in meaning is quite vast. But some of the scholars say, if we are sincere, inshallah, we will be chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah says, those worshippers whom He has chosen, they are always saved from the punishment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose us and may He save us from the punishment as well. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about Yunus alayhi salatu wassalam. And Allah says, he was a person who used to engage in tasbih. He used to always praise Allah on every condition. So when he was in the belly of the whale, Allah says, and listen to the verse,
فَلَوْلَا أَنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ لَلَبِثَ فِي بَطْنِهِ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ.
If he was not from amongst those who constantly praised us, he would have probably lived in the belly of the whale up to the day of Qiyamah. But because we know that he used to remember us at times of ease, when it was a time of difficulty for him, we answered his call and we removed him from the belly in a very short time. So the hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, تَعَرَّفْ إِلَى اللَّهِ فِي الرَّخَاءِ يَعْرِفْكَ فِي الشِّدَّةِ. Get close to Allah, remember Allah at times of ease and Allah will remember you at times of difficulty. Something very simple. Remember Allah at times of ease, when you don't have health problems, when you don't have financial problems, when you don't have marital problems, when your children are obedient, remember Allah, thank Him, praise Him, worship Him, read your 5 salah. The day you are in trouble, Allah will come to your assistance directly. That is the lesson we learn from this. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant that to us. Then the next surah is Surah Sad.
where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about Dawood alayhi salam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of the gifts given to Dawood and Sulaiman. These two were kings and they were prophets at the same time. Now, one point we need to clarify here. If we take a look at the Old Testament that has now been changed, we will find that they swear most of the prophets. Sulaiman and Dawood, they write very bad things about them. Lut alayhi salam, Lot, they write evil things about him and his daughters, and they accuse him of having done very bad things. The same applies to all other prophets. They have chosen where and how they want to speak bad about these prophets, and it's full of it, believe me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us these books have been changed. Allah cannot send a messenger who is not the best of the people. We ourselves will not appoint one of the religious leaders if we know that he is a person who's involved in sin day and night. Isn't that correct? So if our own brains tell us that if you want a religious personnel or religious personnel who are effective and in community, who have a great impact in community, you have to choose those who are good and respected. You can't choose people who are disrespected by the whole society and they are engaged in sin day and night. Yes, they might have, in the case of us and human beings, they might have weaknesses. But not manifest clear weaknesses where no matter how many times they are told or reminded, they still engage in that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also, whenever He chose His messengers, He chose the best and He protected them from sin. He protected them. So Lut alayhi salam, Sulaiman and David, Dawood meaning Solomon, and these people who were leaders and prophets, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we chose them from amongst the best. And that's why the term mukhlas means those who were carefully selected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah grant us the ability to respect all the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We believe in them. We respect them. We will not blaspheme them. We don't believe in what is uttered against them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about Dawood and Sulaiman alayhi salatu wa salam. And Allah says,
إِنَّهُ أَوَّابٌ.
Dawood alayhi salam was often returning to Allah. He always returned to Allah. He always remembered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May He also make us from amongst those who always return to Him. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about how when He used to do tasbih, when He used to make the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even the mountains used to do the dhikr with Him.
Ya jibalu awibi ma'ahu wat-tayra.
The mountains and the birds were instructed that whenever Dawood makes dhikr, you make dhikr with him. Imagine if I had to say, Subhanallah, and suddenly the mountains and the birds are all saying the same thing with me. That was granted to Dawood alayhi salatu wassalam. And his son, Sulaiman alayhi salatu wassalam, he was able to communicate with the wind. He made a dua, Rabbi ighfir li وَهَبْ لِي مُلْكًا لَا يَنْبَغِي لِأَحَدٍ مِّن بَعْدِي إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَّابُ. Oh Allah, forgive me and grant me kingdom that you shall not grant anyone after me. And surely Allah granted him certain aspects that no one after him was granted, like the speaking to the wind and so on. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَسَخَّرْنَا لَهُ الرِّيحَ تَجْرِي بِأَمْرِهِ. We made easy for him. We gave him control of the winds that used to move with his command. When he instructs the wind, imagine if you could talk to the wind and say, now blow that way, and the wind blew. Allahu Akbar, that was granted to Sulaiman alayhi salatu wassalam. Please let's not go outside and try that, because with us, we are not Sulaimans. We are not prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Sulaiman alayhi salam was granted that. He was told that you have control of the winds, and also he could speak to the birds and the animals and all the creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That was the power of Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave that to him. And Allah speaks about how Ayyub alayhi salam was tested. Remember in Surah Sa'd, Allah speaks about how the prophets were tested, and Allah speaks about how they turned to Allah. Do you know, I would like you to go through the story of Ayyub alayhi salatu wa salam. Job, Ayyub alayhi salatu wa salam, he was tested in such a big way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not easily name someone very patient. Imagine if the Creator says, that man, we tested him and we found him to be very patient. Allahu Akbar. Allah says, Inna wajadnahu sabira. We found him to be so patient. Allahu Akbar. With us, A person dies close to us, wife or children or parents or someone this side, that side. We are informed that we have this disease, that disease. We lose hope. We begin to question Allah. We lose our iman in the process sometimes. Small test. Ayyub alayhi salam go through his tests. He was tested in a huge way. Allah says we tested him. He passed the tests. We gave him so much in return because we found that he was from amongst those who was very patient. Allah praises Ayyub alayhi salam in the Quran and Allah says, Ni'mal abdu, what a good worshipper he is. Imagine if Allah has to tell that to us on the day of Qiyamah. What a good worshipper he is. Allahu Akbar. May Allah grant that to us. But we also need to give reason for that to happen. May Allah make that easy for us as well. Allah says, Ni'mal abdu innahu awwab. What a good worshipper was Ayyub. He also turned to us very, very often. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst those who turns to him very, very often. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about Iblis and how Iblis told Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I am going to show you that they won't worship you, they will worship everything besides you. They won't call out to you, they will call out to everything besides you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after having given a little bit of time to Iblis, he told Iblis,
لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ مِنْكَ وَمِنْ مَنْ تَبِعَكَ مِنْهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ
I am going to fill Jahannam with you, O Iblis, and with anyone who decides to follow you. With anyone who decides to follow you. May Allah protect us from Iblis. May he keep us far away from him and his progeny. And may Allah not make us from amongst those who follow Iblis. Sometimes we sin. But again, I must repeat that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says we need to turn often to Allah. Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal. Don't lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After that, there is a surah known as Surah Az-Zumar, where Allah speaks of the groups or the armies that go into Jannah and Jahannam. The groups, the parties, groups of people who go into Jannah and Jahannam, inshallah, we will look at that tomorrow and we will go through those verses because we are going to read them tomorrow, inshallah, in Taraweeh. But for today, at the beginning of Surah Az-Zumar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about how man is, once again. And this verse has repeated itself.
وَإِذَا مَسَّ الْإِنسَانَ ضُرٌّ دَعَى رَبَّهُ مُنِيبًا إِلَيْهِ
When evil befalls man, then man turns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, save me from this evil. Ya Allah, protect me.
ثُمَّ إِذَا خَوَّلَهُ نِعْمَةً مِّنْهُ نَسِيَ مَا كَانَ يَدْعُو إِلَيْهِ مِنْ قَبْلِ وَجَعَلَ لِلَّهِ أَنْدَادًا لِيُضِلَّ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of how when the person is taken out of the evil that had befallen them, they forget Allah. They carry on earth as though there was never a day when they needed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah is mentioning that here. May we not be from amongst those. We know we are in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may we turn to him and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fulfill our needs. For he is the only one who can do that. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encourages all of us to learn. To acquire knowledge that is beneficial. Any knowledge that is beneficial. Allah asks a question.
قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ
Ask them a question, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Those who know and those who don't know. Those who have knowledge and those who don't have knowledge. Are they equal? No, they are not equal. So learn. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us knowledge. So that we can actually be better and we can know what we have to know as human beings. We can benefit others and benefit ourselves as well. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the losers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the losers are the ones who lose their family members on the day of Qiyamah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about those people who will be separated from their family members. Those people who will be separated from their loved ones on the day of Qiyamah. Why? Their deeds are totally different. One's deeds were heading in one direction, the other's deeds were heading in the other direction.
إِنَّ الْخَاسِرِينَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَهْلِيهِمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ
The losers are those who lost themselves on the day of Qiyamah and they lost their family members. Or another translation, their family members also lost. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us and safeguard us. May he unite us with our family members in the dunya as well as in the akhirah. May he not make us from amongst those who are losers in the akhirah. Rather, may we be winners at all times. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to use this month of Ramadan in a way that it can be of benefit to us, and in the way that we can turn to Him. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad.